Best individual episode of an anime series.
Individual episode.
Of any anime series you've seen.
Cowboy Andy from Cowboy Bebop.
Okay, well, not. Okay, Cowboy. What's that episode like?
Yeah,
that's
individual.
How do I describe that episode? Well, it's, have you ever watched, Cowboy Bebop?
No.
Well, the main character is supposed to be a badass and kind of meets his rival in the form of a guy who wants to be a real-life cowboy.
Yeah.
He has thieves that can follow him around.
Cool.
Yeah, the guy's completely awesome.
Cool. Anyone else?
I say the beginning, Noen.
Of Noen?
No, the beginning. That's the episode's title. It's the beginning. It's the last episode.
Of Noen?
Yes.
Okay.
It's called The Beginning.
Okay, how's that? How's the name spelled?
N-O-E-I-N.
Okay.
Well, Haruka, who has been having these strange visions, finally is about to realize everything. And that
okay.
The most evil person she's been trying to face is actually her best friend. And then at the very end, there's this beautiful scene where these shreds of dimension are falling all over. It's beautiful.
Okay.
Future episode from
Ping Pong Club. Okay, future episode.
By the way, I rode that cable car in Hokkaido last year.
Hey, what's that so
it
like?
It looks like that. I mean, we went there because of knowing. It's a great place to
go. What's the future episode so like?
Have you ever seen Ping Pong Club?
No, I haven't.
Okay, Ping Pong Club is a South Park version.
Nice.
South Park version.
Oh, wow.
And the guys act out the glorious birthing of eggs by sea tourists using ping pong balls.
Sounds funny.
Forest of Thorns. Marry me, Tim.
Okay, Forest of Thorns. What's that like?
It's backstory on one of the main supporting characters.
Okay.
Marry me, Tim. Pretty much the character is generally pretty much the female equivalent of a playboy.
Nice.
But it's pretty much the backstory about the first time she fell in love and
okay.
How it failed.
Wow.
It's sad, but it's also really quite touching in my opinion.
Okay.
And afterwards, she's pretty much screwed society's views. I'm
going to go Wow. Okay.
I have to go with the Trigon episode where Wolf went
down. No!
Wolf went
down. Why would you do that to me?
Cruel.
Worst episode of my life.
Okay, what do you like about that? What do you ironically like about that episode?
It was very, very emotional. I don't think I've ever really felt bad for another anime character as I did about Millie. I mean, she's this giant of a woman, and she has just fallen in love with Wolfwood, who is supposedly a traveling priest, who is actually an assassin. And so she's finally found love the first time in her life, and she loses him the next day.
Wow. Okay.
Episode 1 of Coyote Ragtime Show.
Okay, Coyote Ragtime Episode 1. What's that like?
Okay, well, it beat out one of the episodes in Black Lagoon where you've got the maid who's protecting that kid from South America and
yeah.
She's got, like, grenades under her skirt and a bulletproof parasol and stuff like that.
Oh, my God, that's so cool.
Oh, it was. And by the way, plug, there's an AMV to that in the show, which is hilarious. Okay, but that got topped by Coyote Ragtime Show because you just have a cluster fox trot of so many things going on, and then the rest of the show sucks after that. So, they're going to spring this guy out of a prison, and there's a prison planet. The reason it's a prison planet is because there's this chunk of rock in the middle of the desert, and the reason that's a great place for a prison is, well, we've got bugs, this is a little thing. They're taking this hover car out there. It's a little thing. What does that do? It keeps the bugs away. And they turn it off. And this thing the size of a dune sandworm goes, out of the sand. Oh, those bugs. Okay, get that twiddly thing going. Yeah, thank you. And then while they're doing that, a crime syndicate wants to spring the same brilliant criminal out because they want to use him for one of their ops. the syndicate has 12 goth, lowly, android-made combat helicopter insertion shock troops using, wait, aren't we in like the 24th-something century? We're using early World War I and World War II weapons, including... You think it's a German potato masher. You've seen those? You know, you ever seen a potato masher grenade? Okay. And I don't know if we can sketch.
Okay. Here we go.
Right. Okay. You see this. It, you know, they get all the details right. If you've ever seen, unlike American grenades, which are, you know, Americans play baseball. When we built grenades, we built something about baseball size. What do? Pull the pin, throw it like a baseball. Or pretty much. Okay. The Germans, they had potato masher. What?
Actually,
okay, as I said, not really. I mean, I did, but basically, it's something familiar. So, you know how to do these? You twist the handle to arm it, and then also because this has got a lever on, you can throw it. All right. However, if you look carefully, there she is. She's got 6 charges attached to this thing. So, and then there's a string at the bottom that she arms it with. It's the Japanese knockoff of the so she's got a Japanese World War II knockoff of the German potato masher in the year 2470 something on some other planet, and they've got, you know, you've got the ring of goth lowly paratroop insertion combat maids that take out the prison to spring this guy to kidnap this guy. It's insane.
Okay.
The rest of the show, so.
Okay. Any other choices? Okay, Kenshin. I'll just put Kenshin 5.
Yeah, you're right. I meant. But it's the same, similar size compared to Germans.
No.
Yeah, but
okay. What do you like about the Kenshin fighting episode?
Yeah, you're right.
What do you like about the Kenshin fighting episode?
That one episode was just up until then the series was like haha romance comedy with some fighting, and after that point, like, that was the point where it really defined, yeah, we're gonna have to kick ass fight.
Haha, nice.
Up in like all the rest of the series, and that really, that fight more bounced off the walls and like killed each other.
Cool. Any other choices? Okay. You have one? Okay.
Well, continuing that subject, maybe the Kenshin Trust and Betrayal?
Okay, Kenshin Betrayal episode.
It's actually a movie, so I'm not sure if it would count.
Yeah. That wasn't really an episode.
Okay, well, okay, I won't count that. Okay.
OVAs do not count.
No, not really. Okay. Okay, before we do the voting, I'm going to mention a few choices that I'm a little surprised no one mentioned that I think a lot of you are going to agree with. One, Full Metal Alchemist episode 36. The Flame Alchemist, the Bachelor Lieutenant, and the Mystery of Warehouse 13.
Oh, yeah.
Another one, the play episode of Ouran Host Club.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Okay.
I have one more.
Oh, okay.
Okay,
we're gonna vote on the choices that have made it.
Oh, now I remember now.
Okay.
Okay. It's the Inuyasha episode where Kikyo dies.
Okay, Kikyo.
I was not expecting that at all.
Okay, what happened? What do you like about the episode?
They were all on this mountain looking for demons, and it was this really unsuspecting time, and all of a sudden she dies. But Raku comes back as a super powerful being.
Okay.
And everything is turned for the worst.
Okay. Okay, what about you?
I came in late. What are we...
We're talking about the best individual episode of an anime series. And we're going to vote on the choices.
I would say one was the... I can't remember the number of it, because...
Yeah, right now we're voting on the choices selected.
Oh, we're voting now?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Full Metal Alchemist one you just
had. Okay. Yeah, okay.
I vote for the last episode, no one.
Okay.
I'll still go with Cody Rex on show.
Okay.
I'll have to stick with the Death and Wolfwood.
Okay.
I agree.
Me too.
Add 3 more to that.
3 more.
Okay.
There's a winner right there.
Okay.